Hi, my name is Brian Lung, and I am part of the US National Science Foundation, and I am supporting the Belmont Forum as secretary for this collaborative research action on climate, environment, and health. In this brief video, I will go through four main points. The first one is CRA details. Second, I will talk about timeline. Third, I will talk about the capacity building activities. And fourth, I will talk about eligibility. The Belmont Forum is organizing a call on climate, environment, and health because we found that the research community is asking for it, and there are a lot of research gaps that need to be addressed and applied, such as extreme heat, dehydration, and renal disease, higher carbon dioxide and reduced crop nutrition, or current drought adaptation behaviors propagating vector-borne diseases. The impacts on human or ecological health can be direct, like wildfires, or indirect through zoonotic spillovers, which lead to major health effects, especially with people living with non-communicable diseases or disproportionately affected communities. This CRA, or Collaborative Research Action, will address several goals. These goals are listed over here, for example, can range from the creation of early warning systems to developing a community of practice. Regardless of what goals you choose, they must address these three themes: theme A, decision science of environmental behavior and implementation, in other words, nature-based solutions, implementation science, or linking science to policy and informed decision-making. Next, theme B, food, environment, and biological security. In other words, foodborne, waterborne, and vector-borne diseases. And lastly, theme C, ecological and environmental health. From these themes, you must choose A, then you can choose B and/or C. In this CRA, we have four key dates to remember. The first one is 15th of April is when the BFGO, our online portal for submissions, is opened. Next is the 15th of July. That is when pre-proposals will close, and then we will have a panel of experts review these proposals. And those proposals with a concrete idea and proposal will be invited to move on to the full submission, which will be due sometime in January 2024. The final kickoff for the projects will be June 2024 at SRI, the Sustainability Research Innovation Congress. So at this point, you might be wondering, why are there so many months in between the start date and the submission final date? Well, that's because we have voluntary capacity building activities that range from virtual to in-person activities hosted by our partners and coordinated through the National Science Foundation, as you can see here in this timeline, starting from networking, training, and meeting. Then you see the selection process. The proposals will close in January, and then they will start in June. I do want to emphasize, these capacity building activities are completely voluntary, and they will not impact your proposal at all. However, if you would like to strengthen your proposal, you are welcome to attend these activities. They can be found on the Belmont Forum website calendar by scanning this QR code or by going to our website, www.belmontforum.org. There are three main types of events. They can be programmatic, they can be communication or educational, or they can be the office hours and networking. And the full list of activities are on the website, but these are examples of the main themes to the far right-hand side of this slide. The next question you're probably thinking is, this sounds great, but am I eligible? Well, to simplify the process, think of the rule of three. The projects must have three different people from three different countries with three different specialties. And by specialties, I mean natural scientists, social scientists, or a stakeholder in civil society or government slash the ministry. The full list of criteria can be listed on our website and on the CRA itself. At this point, feel free to pause the video because this is a huge list of countries. And if you are from these countries, you are likely to be eligible for this collaborative research action on climate, environment, and health. One final point on eligibility. You should check the annex, which is found under the CRAs for climate and environmental health, and look for the specific funding or institution that can fund your country. The annex is divided into four main parts. The first part is monetary, next is personnel requirements, third is going to be duration, and lastly is the point of contact. If there are any confusions in the annex that doesn't make any sense, remember to contact the point of contact person that's listed within the annex, who can clarify some of the questions and points that you have. Also, pay very close attention to the personnel requirements to make sure you are eligible within your country. Lastly, don't forget to pause the video here and scan the QR codes to stay up to date with our social media. Our social media is most likely the main way we will advertise when the next capacity building events will be, and if we announce a new partner or funder who will join this call. So, pause, scan, click, and subscribe. If you have any other additional questions, feel free to reach out to us via email using info@belmontforum.org and in the title put in CEH2, and it will be directed to me, and I will answer your email. And thanks for listening. And don't forget to subscribe to all our socials and stay tuned for more updates on this CRA, Climate, Environment, Health.